Dear brothers, today we listen to the parable of the 10 virgins. Of course, this parable is based on a fact, a situation of ordinary life. It tells of a custom connected with the wedding celebration. The virgins, the 10 young girls, went to the bride's house, waiting with her until the bridegroom came to lead her to his home. Then people went in a procession to the wedding hall. But it happens that unusual, even unlikely traits are introduced into a narrative to make a point. There are several in our case. The interminable lateness of the bridegroom, who keeps people waiting until the middle of the night, and the 5 foolish virgins wanting to buy oil as if they thought it possible to find a shop open at that hour, the closing of the banquet hall door, so contrary to the customs of Oriental hospitality, and so scandalous on the part of the bridegroom, who acted so thoughtlessly. His retort to the latecomers, "I do not know you." To this, we could add the fact that the young girls who had taken a supply of oil are not reproached for refusing to share. It would be out of place to argue with these improbable features of the story. We must remember, a parable is not a narrative of an event, retold with exactitude down to its minutest details. Storytellers can legitimately put in exaggerated traits that fit their purposes. We must understand the lesson of the parable. We shall be kept waiting for the Lord's coming. Unforeseeable. It will happen suddenly. At that moment, everything will be lost for those who were taken by surprise. Our parents cannot help us. Friends cannot help us. Those who are not ready will find a closed door in the kingdom where the wedding of the Son of Man is celebrated. Therefore, we must understand why and in what sense the 5 foolish virgins are foolish. They showed that folly, that lack of wisdom characterizes those who do not reckon with God. As the psalmist says, they have acted impiously. Psalm 14 verse 1 says, "The fool says in his heart, there is no God." You are invited to the wedding. Watch, for you know neither the day nor the hour of the Lord's coming. The lesson is a moral one for us, but it results from faith in Jesus, who is, who was, who is coming again, whom we have found, whose return we are expecting. This faith is at the heart of the church's life. Instead of producing anxiety and nervousness, we should guard ourselves from discouragement, carelessness, sleepiness. Believers must have vigilant hearts. The church is the gathering of all those who are preparing to depart in a joyous procession, their lamps in their hands, to meet the bridegroom. Every liturgical celebration, including this Eucharist, is like the dress rehearsal of the great procession to the wedding hall. In any event, the Lord is already here. He comes for His own, to whom He manifests Himself under the veil of signs. So, my dear brothers, let us be vigilant. Let us be awake. Let us not be taken by surprise. Let's go on doing our duty faithfully, patiently, always being ready to meet the Lord, who will reward us according to our deeds. Amen.